All right, in this one I would like to present the Arch install utility. So recently I had to once again install Arch Linux on a computer, and Arch Linux has this reputation of having a very tough and manual install, which I did multiple times. But at some point it's just like it's just a meme, and you just reading through man pages and not really learning anything new. So it loses a bit its purpose and its fun. But I still like Arch Linux very much, and I like to use it on a daily basis. So I was looking for some scripts for my new install that I had to do, and apparently now Arch Linux just comes out of the box with an installer. It's just a script called Arch install, and so yeah, it worked very well, and I'm just gonna run through it quite quickly and just show how it works. So yeah, set up a little virtual machine here that has already the Arch Linux ISO loaded up. So yeah, it's booting, and yeah, finally, Arch Linux is painless to install, which is a relief, and since now I can use it, install it without pain. So yeah, you just end up in the shell as you usually do, and beforehand you do have to check that you have internet. Like that's maybe the only manual step that you have to do. Like, well, if you have an Ethernet cable, that's easy. But if you need to connect to Wi-Fi, there is some extra steps that you need to follow. But yeah, otherwise you just type Arch install, and that's pretty much it. Then you will end up in this menu where you just fill all the options. And so yeah, just go through the installation. So language in my case, English. Mirrors, you can pick your region. So in me currently it's Switzerland. Go back. Locals, yeah, English keyboard is fine. This configuration, partitioning, and then here that's where you can have like if you already have a home partition from your previous install, you can probably do stuff here. You can always do manual partitioning. In my case, I will use best effort default partitioning layout. You have to pick a disk on which to do the partitioning and install the OS. You have to pick the format of the file system, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So yeah, I think that's it. Disk encryption, you can encrypt your disk. I won't do it in my case, but if you do, you have to set a password. You can pick a bootloader. Grub is fine. Select if you want to swap. Change the host name. Arch install test. You can set a root password. In my case, I will leave it blank. You can add multiple users. So in my case, let's add a user that is me. Yes, I want to be sudo, and then you can add more or just go back to the main menu, profile, and here you can pick like a very minimal install for a server, just basic Xorg. If you pick desktop, it's gonna propose to use some window managers and desktop environments. I'm just gonna pick minimal. Yep, this. Kernels, you can have yeah, just LTS or hardened, stuff like that. The default one is fine. Additional package is just install NeoFetch so that I can show you how after that it works. Network configuration, sure, network manager is always nice. It's easy if you're just wondering. You can pick your time zone, synchronize the time to a server, and yeah, other repositories for Pacman. And then after all that is done, you can save the configuration, which will just write a JSON where you can, if like, I would suggest doing this before, because if like when you press install, it will run the script, and if it crashes in the middle, you will have to redo all those steps. So it's just nice if you just save the configuration before, so that you can, then you can just do like Arch install, and then there is some options to load some configuration so that you can not redo all those manual steps. And then, yeah, you just press install and it will do the stuff for you. So that's the configuration it's showing. Unfortunately, yeah, it's like not showing the very bottom, but right now it's doing a countdown until Yeah, it's doing a countdown until it formats the disk. And so now it it starts to format the disk. And I will take you back when it's done. All right, it is done. And now once it ends, it asks you, do you want to go in a shell of your install? So it will change the route to your actual install. So let's say, just say yes. And you see that we have a NeoFetched install and ArchLink is installed, but I will actually reboot the computer so that I can show that it works. Can I just do reboot? Oh, or just exit and reboot from here. I hope that works. Okay. Oh, I don't want... Can I do ArchLink? Okay. So that's the existing OS. So, yep, I can log in. Oops. Let's up and yeah, that's it. You have a fresh Arch Linux install. And yeah, maybe I should do a video on like what you do after your minimal install. Like how do you install a window manager, Xorg, audio, and stuff like that, because all of that is still manual. Although with the install script, you can also do a desktop environment, audio, and basic stuff like that. But yeah, anyway, tell me what you think. It was really nice to discover this, and it's really nice that it's just built in into the ISO of the install image of Arch Linux now. So yeah, I'm quite happy about it, and I hope it helps. And yeah, see you.